In other news, a Philippine radio station apologizes for a report which claimed that campaign organizers of Vice President Leni Robredo had pocketed money meant for her supporters. The report aired by DZRH Monday said organizers of a caravan for Robredo's presidential bid had kept the money for themselves. The organizers called the report malicious. They deny the caravan participants were paid to join the event in Northern Samar. DZRH issued an erratum and apologized to Robredo and the caravan participants. DZRH station manager Cesar Chavez says they've suspended the correspondent who filed the report without substantiating it. Robredo thanked Chavez for immediately addressing the issue.
Labor leader Leody de Guzman says he's willing to withdraw his 2022 presidential bid if Vice President Robredo will back his advocacies. De Guzman says, while Robredo has proven to be a true opposition candidate, she should also focus on other issues apart from preventing a return of the Dutertes or Marcoses to Malacanang.
Kung hindi niya tatanggapin at ayaw niya magsalita tungkol sa kontraktualisasyon, ayaw niya magsalita tungkol sa rice tariffication law, ayaw niya magsalita tungkol sa VAT, value-added tax, ayaw niya magsalita tungkol sa sistema ng eleksyon natin, na para sa mga may bilyonaryo lang. Ayaw niya magsalita tungkol dun sa sektor ng serbisyo na napunta sa mga privado ay gusto natin bawiin at hawakan ng gobyerno. Tutuloy ko ang laban ko kung hindi rin lang niya tatanggapin.
De Guzman also addressed concerns his candidacy will just split opposition votes, saying he and Robredo have a different voter base.
Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio asked her supporters not to push through with a planned caravan that aims to convince her to run for president next year. The caravan is scheduled for tomorrow, November 4, and will be done from Cotabato to Manila. But on her Facebook page, Duterte Carpio appealed to her supporters to cancel it, citing COVID-19 risks. Instead, she says the money allotted for the event should be used to help those in need. The Davao mayor has filed her candidacy for re-election in 2022, but several groups and personalities, including the ruling party PDP Laban standard bearer Ronald Bato de la Rosa, are still trying to change her mind. Various civic groups have filed a petition before the Commission on Elections seeking to cancel or deny due course to the Certificate of Candidacy for President filed by former Senator Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. The groups accuse Marcos of false material representation, citing his conviction for tax evasion. Marcos was convicted for failing to file his income tax returns from 1982 to 1985. Petitioners say mere conviction disqualifies him from running for any public office. They add the tax evasion conviction carried with it a mandatory penalty of more than 18 months jail time, which is a ground for disqualifying him from running for any public office under the Omnibus Election Code. Petitioners also argue Marcos's repeated failure to file his income tax returns and the failure to pay estate tax initially amounting to 23 billion pesos, but is now worth more than 203 billion pesos, are crimes involving moral turpitude. Lastly, petitioners claim that in his COC, Marcos falsely declared under oath that he's eligible to run for president and also lied about never having been found liable for any offense.
In business, Sudeno Corporation asserts the legality of its acquisition of shares in the Malampaya Gas Project. In a statement, Sudeno spokesperson Raymond Zorrilla said, the transfers of Chevron and Shell shares underwent strict bidding process and due diligence by all parties involved. He added the share sales were above board and legal. Zorrilla also said the issue of the Malampaya deal has been highly politicized. Dennis Uy Zudena purchased Chevron's 45% share in Malampaya for $565 million and Shell's 45% stake for $460 million. And Energy Secretary Alfonso Pusti are facing a graft complaint over the deal. Complainants said the alleged anomalies in the deal caused government billions of pesos.